SolidJS is a front-end JavaScript framework that has been gaining quite some traction and popularity over the last couple of months. So that, of course, brings up two important questions. What is SolidJS and why do we need another front-end JavaScript framework? SolidJS is created by Ryan Carniato and, as mentioned, it is a front-end JavaScript framework. And I would say there are two main reasons for its popularity. First, when you create a new SolidJS project, which is super easy to do, you're greeted with code that looks a lot like React. It looks like a React app on first sight. You have your component functions, which return JSX code. You can create components and pass props between these components. It looks like React. Until we start managing state, because that's where we have the biggest difference between the two frameworks. In React, if we want to manage state, we use the useState hook typically, and we get back an array with two elements, where the first element is our current state snapshot, and the second element is a function that we can use to update the state. Whenever we call that function, the new state is saved by React, and it re-executes the component function to which the state belonged and all its child component functions. It then takes all that updated JSX code, creates a virtual DOM snapshot, compares that to the previously stored virtual DOM snapshot, and if there are any differences between the two snapshots, it reaches out to the real DOM and updates that real DOM in the place where it needs updating. That's how React works. Now in SolidJS, you call createSignal instead of useState, but you still get back an array with two elements, your state value and an updating function. Sounds familiar, right? Yeah, but that's where the similarities end. In SolidJS, your component functions are only executed once, never twice, never more often than that, only once initially when the app starts, basically. The JSX code is taken and compiled and translated to the real DOM, and all the places in your JSX code where you used these signal values are in the end, you could say, memorized by SolidJS. And when you then update that signal value, when you update the state, so to say, SolidJS directly reaches out to the real DOM to that memorized place in the real DOM to update that part of the UI. So it's not comparing any virtual DOM snapshots, it's not doing anything like that, it just memorizes the reactive places and updates them as your state changes. Now this approach is not necessarily new, but it's different from what React does, and it offers two significant advantages. The first advantage is that since it's updating the UI like this, performance is better. There is no comparison going on behind the scenes, no virtual DOM snapshots that must be managed, hence SolidJS offers a better performance. But the second advantage is probably what makes it so popular. It offers a way easier mental model, and it offers less pitfalls for developers like you and me to step into. For example, since component functions execute only once, you can set a timer in them, or an interval, or send an HTTP request, and then update the state once it's done. In React, you couldn't do anything like that. If you set a timer in a React component and you update the state when a timer expires, that state update triggers the component function to execute again, hence the timer is set again, hence the state is updated again, component function, that's an infinite loop. In SolidJS, you don't have that problem. The component function executes only once. State updates have no impact on that. And therefore, you can safely set a timer and update the signal once the timer expires and everything will be good and the DOM will be updated and nothing else will happen. So there is a totally different reactivity system at work and a totally different mental model to use. Code-wise, it's almost the same. The main difference is that you must execute your state values as functions in the JSX code. And if you pass them through props, you must not use prop destructuring, since that would break SolidJS reactivity system. Of course, sometimes you might have certain values that are derived from state values, and that's also easy to implement with SolidJS, but since component functions are only executed once, you would also create such computed values as functions that you call in your JSX code. SolidJS will automatically make sure that they're only executed and only updated in the DOM when the underlying signal value changed. You can also use the built-in create memo function to cache values and avoid unnecessary recomputations of your computed values. And if you have some side effect that should be executed as some signal value changes, you can use the built-in create function. That function allows you to execute some function of your choice whenever a signal value changes. And again, just as with computed values, SolidJS ReactJS will automatically take a look at the dependencies of your effect function, so at the signal values you're using in there, and only re-execute that effect function, and only that, not the component function, just that, as such signal values change. For asynchronous values, like data fetched from some backend server, you can use the createResource function offered by SolidJS, which in the end also gives you a signal value that's used as such in your JSX code, but which is set and updated asynchronously by SolidJS, and which also gives you some utility properties provided by SolidJS that help you find out if SolidJS is currently fetching the data or if maybe some error occurred. In addition to all that, SolidJS also supports refs, though with a simpler syntax than what you have to write in React. It gives you a context API that looks pretty much identical to what you have in React, and it gives you a store which you can use for more complex state management where regular signals might not suffice. Last but not least, the SolidJS core members are not just working on SolidJS, this amazing framework, which is so easy to learn if you have worked with React before, but they also work on Solid Start, which essentially is an alternative to Next.js and Remix, which helps you build full-stack applications with SolidJS, where you can have some code on the server side, some code on the client side, and both sides work together seamlessly. So, sounds like SolidJS is the better React, isn't it? Well, it certainly is interesting. It has a couple of very nice features, but you must not forget that React is way bigger. It's backed by Meta, it's used by thousands of companies out there, there are thousands of jobs available for React, the ecosystem is bigger, there are more resources on React, more tutorials and so on, and therefore SolidJS is probably not about to replace React anytime soon, though it of course might be worth a closer look for your own projects. And as you saw, switching from React to Solid, and therefore of course also back, isn't too complicated, so in my opinion, it's a framework to play around with, to keep in mind, and it's not just yet another front-end JavaScript framework.